Hey, what's up guys? This is Vincent, and in this Lightroom Classic tutorial, I'm going to show you how to copy and paste adjustment settings to one image or to multiple images. So let's get started. With this image that I took in the Panama of a museum, I'm just going to apply some basic adjustments so they're visible. I'll increase the vibrance, increase the saturation, increase the clarity, and I'll go to the transform tool and I'll click on auto. Now I'm going to go to this image, which is inside the museum. And the quickest way to copy and paste adjustment settings is by clicking on previous, which will copy the adjustment settings of the previous photo and apply it to this photo. And it copies all the adjustment settings. So in this example, you can see it also copied the transform tool and then the basic panel. But let's say, for example, we don't want to copy everything and just want to select what we want to copy. In that case, we would need to use the copy and paste tool. So here I'm just going to reset this, reset the adjustment settings, and I'll go to this image here and I'll click on copy. And now we have the copy settings, and it will allow you to select which settings you want to copy. And by default, transform is not selected, so that's good. So I'll click on copy. And by the way, you can use the keyboard shortcut Control C or Command C for copy. And for paste, it'll be Control V or Command V. So I'll go to this image here and then I'll press Command V. And as you can see, it applied the adjustment settings minus the transform tool. So the best way to copy and paste adjustment settings is by using the copy and paste dedicated tools as opposed to the previous tool, unless the images are very similar in lighting and scenario. So if we want to apply adjustment settings across multiple images, we'll need to use the sync tool, which will pop up when I select multiple images. So I'll click on this image here and then I'll shift click, and now you'll see the sync button here. Before I make any adjustments, let me show you the photos here. These are photos that I'm going to panoramic stitch later on. So I'll go back to the develop module, and this is the main photo that's selected. This is the first photo. You can see like there's a gray, or actually it's a white background, more on the white side, and the other photos have a grayish background. Hopefully you guys can see that here. But anyways, on this primary photo, I'm just gonna make a few basic adjustments again. Increase vibrance, saturation, decrease the haze, increase clarity, decrease the highlights. I'll go to the calibration. I'll change the hue a little bit and increase the saturation of the blue primary. Now, if I want to apply this setting to all the images, I'll need to make sure this image is selected and make sure these are shift selected. And then I'll click on sync. And now I can automatically synchronize the options here. These look pretty good. So I'll click on synchronize. And now the adjustment settings from this first image are now applied to all the other images. So if I click on the survey view, you can see the adjustment has been made. I'll go back to the develop module. Now, a faster way to sync adjustment settings is by clicking on this toggle here, which will toggle on the auto sync. So if I go to the, let's say, the tone curve here, and I look at all these other photos, you can see the tone curve is not adjusted. I'm just going to make sure I shift click all of them and auto sync is on. Now I will increase the tone curve, increase the midtones, and now you can see all the tone curves are adjusted at the midtones. So that's how you use the copy and paste as well as the sync options. And the best way to copy and paste settings or syncing settings is if the images are very similar in scenery, lighting, scenario, and composition. And now I hope you guys understand how to use the copy and paste tool. If you guys enjoyed this video, give it a like, subscribe, and check out my photography on Instagram. And as always, live easy, sleep breezy, and stay lovely.